Hello, I'm Ed Duke. And in this videotape, we're going to take a look at the 1991 Chrysler, Plymouth, and Dodge passenger car, van, and truck lineup. This program has been developed to provide you, the service technician or service department employee, with an overview of the vehicles and vehicle systems that you'll be servicing in the coming model year. Now, in the first section of this program, we'll take a look at the entire lineup of vehicles and highlight new models, styling, and design changes. And we'll briefly cover some of the engineering changes. And in the second half of the videotape, we'll take a closer look at new major components and systems for both passenger cars and trucks. And we'll highlight some of the technical features in these areas. You know, as a service professional, you play an important role in maintaining customer satisfaction and customer loyalty. Your dedication to quality service is a key to the future success of your dealership and of Chrysler Motors. And remember, satisfied service customers become loyal customers. To help you be the best in service technology, Chrysler Motors Service and Parts Operations strives to provide you with the very best in service training, technical manuals, and timely product information. Once again, we hope that this videotape and the collateral 1991 New Model Highlights reference book provided to your dealership will help better prepare you for your job. And in the coming model year, Chrysler's continuing product improvement process will provide more refinements with expanded designs and engineering innovations, as well as technical improvements that will ensure a competitive posture in the rapidly changing worldwide automotive industry. When it makes its public debut this year, the 1991 Stealth will assume a position of preeminence in the expanding performance image being built by the Dodge division of Chrysler. The latest collaborative effort between Chrysler and MMC, the Stealth will be produced in four models for the U.S. market: a base Stealth, a Stealth ES, a Stealth RT, and the ultimate configuration, the Stealth RT Turbo. Stealth will offer three separate levels of power. Easily the most appealing to the true sports car enthusiast will be the 300 horsepower, fuel-injected 3-liter V6, which features dual overhead cams, 24 valves, twin turbochargers, and twin air-to-air intercoolers. Just below the RT Turbo is a fuel-injected 3-liter dual overhead cam 24-valve V6 with a peak capability of 222 horsepower. This engine will be standard on Stealth ES and RT models. The base Stealth will feature a fuel-injected 164 horsepower 3-liter single overhead cam 12-valve version of the same V6. A dual-mode muffler system on turbo models is controlled by a switch on the instrument panel. Setting the switch to tour automatically increases engine exhaust back pressure below 3,500 RPM for quieter driving in urban areas. Setting the switch to sport unleashes the full power of the engine for peak performance. The RT Turbo model will come standard with a new all-wheel drive system that employs a planetary gear-type center differential in conjunction with a viscous coupling unit. The RT Turbo will also feature, as standard, a new power-assisted, speed-dependent four-wheel steering system. The centerpiece of any true sports car is its suspension system, and the Stealth measures up to the best with a unique four-wheel tow control independent front and rear suspension system. Additionally, electronically controlled shock absorbers actively provide anti-pitch, anti-bounce, anti-dive, anti-squat, and anti-roll control for improved handling and stability. In order to provide maximum braking ability, the Stealth incorporates large ventilated discs at all four wheels for better fade resistance and handling. The RT Turbo has 15-inch rear discs and 16-inch front discs. The other models have 14-inch rear and 15-inch front discs. The RT Turbo is equipped with 4-piston aluminum front calipers, while the other models have 2-piston front calipers. In addition, a 4-wheel anti-lock braking system is standard on the RT and RT Turbo, and optional on the base Stealth and ES models. Stealth's interior was designed side by side with the exterior by designers and engineers. A driver-oriented, functional wraparound cockpit design was the main priority. The ergonomically designed interior features a driver's seat with motorized controls for height, tilt, lumbar support, and side support adjustments. The pure sports car image was enhanced by orange illuminated analog instruments and controls, and the air conditioning system is fully automatic. The car's audio system emphasizes deep bass reproduction for a powerful sound and includes an amplifier with 100 watts of combined power to drive a six-speaker system to impressively high levels of clean, crisp sound. For added safety, a steering wheel mounted airbag restraint system functions in conjunction with the 3-point shoulder lap belts. Positioned to complement, not compete with the other cars in the Dodge line, the Stealth should become an image leader for Dodge Division with its expressive styling and responsive performance. Of course, Chrysler's image as a manufacturer of world-class automobiles will be further perpetuated with a continued production of the 1991 Imperial, the flagship of the corporate line. To round out the luxury line, the prestigious New Yorker Fifth Avenue will be offered to buyers seeking status and the best in comfort attributes. A New Yorker Salon and a Landau model will also be available for value-oriented buyers seeking room, ride, and comfort. The very popular, classically designed Dodge Dynasty and Dynasty LE will again appeal to middle-aged families influenced by quality, technology, traditional styling, and value for the money. For 1991, the Imperial will come standard with a new 3.8-liter V6 MPI engine coupled to a refined ultra-drive 4-speed overdrive automatic transaxle. The 3.8-liter V6 will also be available as an option on the Fifth Avenue and New Yorker Salon. Fifth Avenue and New Yorker models will be equipped with a 3.3-liter MPI V6 engine introduced in 1990. The 3.3-liter engine will also be offered as an option for Dynasty models. Convenience and comfort features have also been refined for 1991. Dynasty and Salon have new heater-only controls, and new heater AC controls on all models except Imperial have isographic symbols for mode identification. The automatic temperature control system on Imperial, Fifth Avenue, and Landau has been refined to increase passenger comfort. And all models have new, long-life, lightweight aluminum refrigerant tubing in place of the steel used previously. Two cellular telephone systems are optional on Imperial and Fifth Avenue. The cars will be wired for the equipment, but the telephones will be vendor-installed at the dealership. Another image car for Chrysler, the Maserati-built TC, will be continued in 1991 as a limited edition luxury sport vehicle. The LeBaron will again be offered in three distinct models for 1991, the LeBaron sedan, coupe, and convertible. The LeBaron sedan offers full-size luxury in a mid-size car with more rear seat legroom than any domestic car in its class and more standard features than any domestic car in its class. The LeBaron sedan will be equipped with the 3-liter MPI V6 engine and 4-speed automatic transaxle. The 4-wheel anti-lock brake system will also be available as an option on the sedan models. Both the LeBaron coupe and convertible will be available in three models, a Highline model, a premium LX model, and a premium GTC model. Three engines will be available in the coupe and convertible for 1991. They are the 2.5-liter EFI, a 2.5-liter SMPI Turbo 1, and a 3-liter MPI V6. In addition, four transaxles will be offered as either standard or options, depending on the model and engine combination selected. They are a 3-speed automatic, a 4-speed automatic, a 5-speed manual, and a 5-speed manual heavy duty. New rear drum brakes are standard on all LeBaron coupe and convertible models, replacing rear disc brakes. high-performance four-wheel disc brakes will remain standard on LeBaron LX models and optional on Highline Coupe and convertible models. In the Plymouth line, the sleek, sporty 1991 Laser will be available in three models: a base Laser equipped with a 1.8-liter single overhead cam MPI four-cylinder engine, a Laser RS equipped with a 2-liter dual overhead cam MPI four-cylinder, and a Laser RS Turbo equipped with a 2-liter dual overhead cam MPI intercooled turbo engine. All models come standard with a 5-speed manual transaxle and are available with an optional 4-speed automatic. A security alarm system will be available for the RS Turbo. Inside the car, a split rear fold-down seat is a new feature for 1991 Lasers. Also, Laser RS and RS Turbo models will have the option of a 6-speaker system available with an AM/FM cassette radio. And a compact disc player is available in Laser models with the Infinity 1 or 2 systems. The stylish, roomy, midsize family sedans in the Spirit Acclaim model lineup will include a base Spirit, a Spirit LE, a Spirit ES, a new Spirit RT model, a base Acclaim, an Acclaim LE, and an Acclaim LX. Depending on the model or equipment package, the Spirit Acclaim models will be available with one of three engines: the 2.5-liter four-cylinder EFI, the 2.5-liter MPI Turbo, or the 3-liter MPI V6. Transaxle availability will be either a 3-speed automatic, a 4-speed electronic automatic, or a 5-speed manual. Inside, the Spirit Acclaim models will have redesigned instrument panel defroster ducts, which provide faster defrosting and more even coverage of the glass. An overhead console with a rounded look is optional for 1991, and a console and floor shift will be available for vehicles equipped with automatic transaxles. The new Spirit RT will feature Chrysler's multi-valve technology and is expected to be one of the world's fastest production sedans. The RT will have a deck lid-mounted spoiler and sport a dip-look paint treatment in all red or all white. The RT will be equipped with a 2.2-liter 16-valve dual overhead cam MPI turbo engine and a 5-speed manual transaxle. The RT will also include suspension modifications to improve high-speed handling, including higher rate springs, higher control strut shock absorbers, and a larger rear sway bar. The Shadow Sundance lineup will be expanded and enhanced in 1991 with the introduction of the Shadow and Sundance America models and with the all-new Shadow Convertible. Priced around $13,000, the Shadow Convertible is expected to be the lowest price convertible available in North America. The convertible will come standard with a 2.5-liter EFI engine and 5-speed manual transaxle. Also available as options are the 2.5-liter Turbo 1 engine and or a 3-speed automatic transaxle. The Shadow Convertible has a gas prop-assisted bifold manual folding top mechanism with attached quarter windows, a plastic rear window, dual flush-mounted header latches, and fixed vent windows in the doors. Increased structural integrity is provided by doors which use a guide pin and socket design, a reinforced windshield header and pillars, added support behind the rear seat, reinforcements added to the quarter panels, doors, and spare tire well, a stiffener added to the cowl, double box sill structures, stiffened sill to rail connections, and a reinforced steering column. Inside, the Shadow Convertible has a fixed rear seat which provides room for two passengers, Unibelt 3-point lap and shoulder belt restraint systems for all four seating positions, and a standard driver position airbag. A cross between a sleek European road car and a spacious American sedan, the Dodge Monaco will be offered in two models for 1991, a base Monaco and a Monaco ES. Both models will come standard with the PRV 3-liter MPI V6 engine and a 4-speed automatic transaxle with overdrive. Numerous improvements have been made to the Monaco powertrain for 1991. These changes will be explained later in the technical features section of this program. For 91, ride and handling have been improved on Monaco. The rear suspension shock absorber valving has been revised to be consistent with new front suspension tuning. Monaco models will also have a new brake master cylinder with a larger reservoir for the front system and a fluid sensor rather than a differential pressure warning switch. A new, more reliable coolant level sensor works in conjunction with the vehicle maintenance monitor on the instrument panel to notify the driver of a loss of coolant and is integral with the coolant reservoir. Exterior changes include redesigned front and rear fascias and heated outside mirrors that operate when the rear window defogger is on. Interior changes include instrument panels with a new full-width knee bolster designed in high-strength unidirectional glass fiber reinforced material and new styling and cloth coverings for the seats. Extensive improvements have also been made for quieter operation and reduction in road, wind, and engine noise. These improvements are explained in more detail in the 1991 new model highlights book provided with this videotape. A leader in front-wheel drive performance engineering, Dodge Daytona will be available in three models: a base Daytona, a Daytona ES, and the Daytona Shelby. The base Daytona and ES model will come standard with a 2.5-liter EFI engine and 5-speed manual transaxle. The Daytona Shelby will come standard with a 2.5-liter MPI Turbo 1 engine and the 5-speed manual high-output transaxle. The 3-liter MPI V6 engine will be offered as an option, as well as a 3-speed and 4-speed automatic transaxle. For models equipped with a 2.5 Turbo 1 engine, the exhaust system has been modified to include a larger muffler with lower back pressure. Daytona models will have major suspension and steering changes for 1991. More information on these changes will be detailed later in this program. Braking system features include four-wheel disc brakes as standard on Daytona Shelby and optional on Daytona and ES models, and new 220-millimeter rear drum brakes as standard on Daytona and ES models. Inside the Daytona, the center console has been made common with a LeBaron coupe and convertible, and a compact disc player is available with the Infiniti 1 and 2 systems. The subcompact two-door hatchback Plymouth and Dodge Colt will be available in a base Colt and a Colt GL for 1991. The base Colt will come standard with a 1.5-liter 12-valve EFI engine and 4-speed manual transaxle. The Colt GL will have the same engine coupled with a 5-speed manual transaxle. Both models will be offered with the option of a 3-speed automatic transaxle for economy and low-line models, and a 4-speed automatic on medium, high, and premium line models. Positioned in the marketplace between subcompact station wagons and the larger minivans, the Plymouth and Colt Vista wagons will be offered again in front-wheel drive and four-wheel drive versions. The standard powertrain package for all models will be a 2-liter MPI engine coupled to a 5-speed manual transaxle. A 3-speed automatic transaxle will be offered as an option on front-wheel drive models only. Chrysler's minivan lineup for 1991 will be introduced with extensive improvements in styling, comfort, and engineering. The minivan line will consist of the Chrysler Town & Country, the Plymouth Voyager, Voyager SE, Grand Voyager SE, Grand Voyager LE, the Dodge Caravan, Caravan SE, a 112-inch wheelbase Caravan CV, Grand Caravan SE, Grand Caravan LE, and a 119.1-inch wheelbase Caravan CV. The Town & Country, Grand Voyager, Grand Caravan, and Extended Caravan CV will come standard with the 3.3-liter MPI V6 engine and 4-speed automatic transaxle. The Voyager, Caravan, and Caravan CV models will come standard with a 2.5-liter EFI engine and 3-speed automatic. These models will also be available with an optional 3-liter MPI V6 or a 3.3-liter V6 and or 4-speed automatic transaxle, depending on model and powertrain option availability. Restyled for 1991, the Town & Country Caravan Voyager lineup features sleeker lines and many new functional exterior improvements. Noticeable are lower hood and front fenders, full wraparound fascias, aero headlamps, turn signals and tail lamps, new side and rear quarter and trim panels, and a redesigned liftgate with a larger glass area. Model and divisional identity will be maintained through unique front grille treatments and model decor packages. Inside, the instrument panel, cluster, and controls are all new, with emphasis on ergonomics and visibility. The climate control systems have been improved to provide increased passenger comfort through better airflow distribution and flow-through ventilation. The Caravan Voyager interior trim is all new and presents an organic, friendly appearance with rounded corners and smoothly blended surfaces. New short and long overhead consoles are available on Caravan Voyager. The short version is included with the optional power sunroof, and the long version is standard on Town & Country. An illuminated entry system is available on Caravan Voyager and is standard on Town & Country. A liftgate courtesy lamp is standard on Town & Country and Caravan Voyager LE models. And an automatic underhood light has been added to the light package. Caravan and Voyager will have all new seats and mechanisms for 1991. Features on Highline models will include reclining front bucket seats with folding inboard armrests. New manual recliners will have finer adjustment increments than any recliner ever offered on a Chrysler Motors product. The driver's bucket seat will have new seat tracks for fore and aft adjustment, in which the operation is more natural and effort is lower than for previous adjusters. New intermediate and rear seats have lighter weight frames and a redesigned floor latch, which makes the seats easier to remove and replace. A new quad command seating package has two bucket seats in the intermediate position. These seats are mounted on fixed risers and use the same attachment to the floor as the bench seats. Both intermediate and rear bench seats have folding backs with carpeted rear panels for added load-carrying versatility. Dual hinge power outside mirrors are new for Caravan Voyager. The hinges have three detent positions: full forward, normal, and full rear. The sliding door has a new interior remote handle with better access and operation. And a standard child protection lock has been added to the sliding door. Also, a sliding door memory lock will be included with optional power door locks. A smoother, quieter, world-class latch for the front doors will be standard on the Caravan Voyager and Town & Country models for 1991. These models will also use the valet key and lock system introduced in 1989 on Spirit Acclaim. The big news for 1991 is the introduction of a sophisticated all-wheel drive system as an option on all Caravan Voyager models equipped with a 3.3-liter V6, ultra-drive 4-speed automatic transaxle, and 15-inch wheels. The all-wheel drive system offers superior straight-line acceleration and cornering on all surfaces, and better traction and handling under adverse conditions, resulting in improved hill climbing ability and safer driving. Four-wheel anti-lock brakes will be standard on Town & Country and optional on all Caravan Voyager models. The anti-lock brakes will become available on all-wheel drive models as a running change during the model year. Exhaust systems have been revised to make them quieter. The changes vary with the engine and vehicle configuration. For further information about these and other changes to Caravan, Voyager, and Town & Country models, refer to the 1991 New Model Highlights book. For 1991, the Dakota pickup line has been further expanded to include a 4x4 option on all of the Club Cab models. Even bigger news for the Dakota line is the availability of an optional 5.2-liter V8 engine, coupled to an A500 four-speed automatic transmission. This new powertrain will be available on all Dakota models except the two-wheel drive S model. With the availability of the V8 engine, the radiator closure panel has been revised and moved forward in the engine compartment. Also, all Dakota wheels are a six lug design to provide the additional clamping force required by the added weight and torque of the optional V8 engine. Larger capacity front brake calipers with 2.6 inch pistons are also used on all Dakota models this year to assure excellent braking performance on models equipped with a 5.2 liter V8. Body styling changes for 1991 include an all-new front end appearance for all models. The new look includes a longer hood, bolder grille, and new bumper. LE and Sport models will feature new aero-styled front grille and lights, a front air dam with integral fog lamps, a rear chrome tube bumper, and a chrome light bar with two off-road lights for 4x4 models. Dakota vehicles will be equipped with an electrical power distribution center to provide maximum circuit overload protection for the primary vehicle electrical system battery feed. The distribution center houses plug-in blade-type fuses, which replace all the inline fusible links used previously. Inside, a new corporate heater AC control panel is introduced on Dakota models to help commonize these components with those in other Chrysler vehicles. An inertia latch seat back retention system is being introduced on Dakota to lock the seat back in place whenever the vehicle decelerates severely. For 1991, the Dodge Ram pickup and Ram Charger models will feature some new exterior styling changes, including a new grille, lower body side and wheel lip moldings, and low mount extended arm mirrors. All models will also have a new redesigned rear bumper for increased towing capacity. Some selected models will also feature new frame rails to increase structural rigidity and improve load carrying ability. Club cab pickups and Ram Chargers will have bench seats with head restraints for the outboard positions. Ram Charger models will have a split back bench seat. For 1991, Ram vans and wagons will be equipped with new dual side and rear doors. Improvements to the doors include a new dual caliper latch on the left door with a paddle type release handle on the shut face, a new world-class low effort latch on the right door, new molded weather seals on both doors to reduce wind noise and resist drafts and moisture, and inner and outer panels of galvanized steel to resist corrosion. Inside, all Ram vans and wagons will have an improved sound absorbing pad on the inside of the dash panel to help reduce interior engine noise. For improved passenger comfort and efficient operation, heater and air conditioning improvements have also been made on all Ram vans and wagons. In wagons with rear air conditioning, a cool air outlet has been added to the trim panel beside the second seat position. On all models, a new scroll-type AC compressor will replace the previously used piston-type compressor, and the AC operation will include a reheat capability in the normal and recirc modes. As a mid-year change, the rear heater will be controlled from the instrument panel control rather than at the heater housing. In the small pickup class, all two-wheel drive Ram 50 models and the short wheelbase four-wheel drive Power Ram 50 will come standard with a 2.4 liter four-cylinder engine. All other four-wheel drive Power Ram 50 models will come standard with a 3-liter six-cylinder engine. In 1991, a rear-wheel anti-lock brake system will be available on Ram 50 models. At the rear axle, a new rear wheel bearing retainer will be used on the Ram 50s. Now, the new design is a press fit bearing retainer and replaces the old washer and lock nut design. Under the hood, a new air cleaner design will ensure smooth intake airflow for higher output. As part of the design, the airflow sensor is now mounted external to the air cleaner. A new fuel injector with a redesigned inner fuel passage will have better vapor preventing characteristics for improved warm engine restarting in high temperature conditions. Well, this concludes our overview of the Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, and Dodge Truck 1991 product preview. For further information, refer to the 1991 New Model Highlights book provided with this videotape. In the second half of this videotape, We'll cover major engineering and component changes and improvements as they apply to all models in the product lines. Now, in the powertrain area, new engine, transaxle, and transmission developments have broadened and improved the available powertrain options for both passenger cars and trucks in 1991. As mentioned earlier, a new 2.2-liter engine will be available in the Dodge Spirit RT package for 1991. The engine is a turbocharged dual overhead cam 16-valve design that turns out 225 horsepower at 6,000 RPM and creates 210 foot-pounds of torque at 4,800 RPM. The central feature of the engine is a one-piece cast aluminum alloy cylinder head in which the valves are arranged at a 29.5-degree included angle for compactness. The head has a shallow pent roof combustion chamber configuration with a central spark plug location, cross-flow porting with the intake side facing the front of the vehicle, individual intake manifold runners and divided ports, and a camshaft support with solid bearing stands to allow camshaft installation from the end of the head. Camshafts are of equal length, made from a common casting. A glass fiber-reinforced cogged belt drives the camshafts, using a unique tooth profile design which matches machined pulleys. The valve train features shaft-mounted roller rocker arms with miniature hydraulic valve lash adjusters, 45-degree seating for intake and exhaust valves, and single chrome vanadium steel valve springs. The cylinder block is the same as the corporate 2.2-liter turbocharged engine. The only change is the addition of a boss on the exterior of the block for a crankcase ventilation tube. The crankshaft and connecting rods are similar to those on the 1990 2.2-liter turbo engine. Pistons are a lightweight forged aluminum design with full floating pins retained by circlips. The exhaust manifold is cast iron construction with short, compact passages. Stainless steel cap screws attach the manifold to the cylinder head and provide clamp force for good sealing at all operating temperatures. High flow injectors mount in the intake manifold runners and are controlled sequentially. To prevent engine overspeed, fuel cutoff is set at 6,700 RPM. The tuned intake manifold has individual runners for each cylinder, fed from a plenum chamber, which supports a 52-millimeter throttle body. A conventional turbocharger with a wastegate actuated by the engine control computer is similar to other Chrysler turbo applications. A direct distributorless ignition system is used and is very similar in design to the system used on the 3.3-liter V6. A single serpentine poly-V belt drives all external power accessories and employs an automatic tensioner which requires no periodic adjustment. For 1991, the 2.5-liter Turbo 1 engine has been improved through an increase in torque peak. The rating increase is the result of revised calibration of fuel control, ignition timing control, and turbocharger wastegate control for more low-speed boost. No hardware changes have been made to increase the torque rating, and the horsepower will remain unchanged. For corporate 2.2-liter and 2.5-liter EFI engines with throttle body injection, the fuel system pressure has been raised from 14.7 psi to 39 psi. The change in operating pressure allows the use of the fuel pump common to both TBI and MPI systems in both naturally aspirated and turbocharged versions of the engine. The MMC 1.5-liter engine in Plymouth and Dodge Colt models has been redesigned for 1991 and now utilizes a 12-valve design. The engine now has two intake valves and one exhaust valve per cylinder for improved performance and increased low-speed torque. The new configuration features redesigned valves and valve springs, pistons, camshaft and camshaft sprocket, cylinder head gasket, timing belt and timing belt cover, and crankshaft pulley. Other changes to the MMC 1.5 include a redesigned distributor with a built-in ignition coil. The distributor has also been relocated to the rear of the cylinder head for direct drive by the camshaft. And the plenum chamber and intake manifold have also been redesigned as an integral one-piece unit. A new 3.8-liter V6 engine will be introduced in 1991. The engine is based on the corporate 3.3-liter V6 introduced last year. The 3.8 produces 150 horsepower at 4,400 RPM and creates 204 foot-pounds of torque at 3,200 RPM. Basically, the 3.8 is the same as the 3.3-liter V6 with a larger cylinder bore and longer stroke. Parts on the 3.8 which differ from the 3.3 are the crankshaft, connecting rods, wrist pins, pistons, head gaskets, and the upper intake manifold. These parts are not interchangeable with the 3.3-liter V6. The 3-liter MMC V6 engine will have a new, smaller automatic tensioner for the accessory drive belt. The tensioner is also relocated, causing a revised belt path. The new tensioner is lighter in weight and will provide quieter operation than the previous design. The PRV 3-liter six-cylinder engine used in Monaco models has also been improved for 1991. Improvements to the engine include an enlarged intake air heater to improve drivability during warm-up, a new throttle body with an integral automatic idle system actuator, a new engine-mounted air cleaner using a tuning Venturi design and pad-type filter, a new direct distributorless ignition system, similar to that on the 3.3-liter corporate V6 engine introduced last year. Changes to the cooling system on the PRV 3-liter engine include a new water pump, a new thermostat, a revised coolant distribution system, revised coolant flow to the heater, dual side-by-side cooling fans, a new coolant reservoir using a conventional radiator cap, and a coolant level sensor located in the reservoir. Even though three engine configurations will be available for the Stealth, all three engines share the same design heritage and engineering sophistication. All three engines displace 181.35 cubic inches from a 3.58-inch bore and a 2.99-inch stroke. The 3-liter engine is a 60-degree V6 design for less noise and vibration. The iron block uses ribbed exterior walls for strength and has thin wall, short skirt construction for reduced weight. Pistons are thin wall aluminum alloy reinforced with steel struts and driven by forged connecting rods. The cylinder heads incorporate compact pent roof combustion chambers with large squish areas and a center spark plug. The cylinder heads feature cogged belt-driven camshafts, which actuate the cross-flow intake and exhaust valves of each cylinder for exemplary combustion efficiency. The camshafts power oversized valves through aluminum roller rocker arms, which are pivoted towards the center of the cylinder head with automatic valve lash adjusters placed by each pivot. Another major feature of this engine is the computer-controlled digital multi-port fuel injection system. Optimum fuel air ratio and amount mixture are calculated by the computer according to throttle opening, engine RPM, intake air volume, coolant temperature, and barometric pressure. Ignition timing control is carried out by a distributorless dual coil system that electronically controls the spark advance angle. In the turbo version of the engine, each three-cylinder bank has its own independent turbo and intercooler. Featuring a lighter turbine wheel, the turbos have been modified for better response from low engine speeds and less boost lag, while the wastegate port is separate from the turbine output port for improved performance at mid-level and high RPMs. The pressurized air from the turbos is cooled by twin air-to-air intercoolers, which receive cooling air through separate air intakes on either side of the air dam. This increases the density of the intake charge for significantly improved power, torque, and responsiveness. For Dodge truck and van applications, the 3.9, 5.2, and 5.9-liter gasoline engines will have a new cylinder head gasket. The new gasket design is made of a graphite base, non-asbestos material, and better resists oil and coolant leaks than the previous design. At mid-year, the 5.9-liter Cummins turbo diesel will be equipped with an aluminum intercooler to help reduce exhaust emissions. The intercooler, or air-to-air heat exchanger, will be mounted in front of the radiator. Also at mid-year, the Cummins diesel will be equipped with an SBEC II single-board engine control module. A new vane-type vacuum pump will replace last year's dual diaphragm pump on Cummins turbo diesel engines. The A518 overdrive automatic transmission will be available at mid-year for use with the intercooled Cummins diesel in conventional cab Ram pickup models. Chrysler's ultra-drive 4-speed automatic transaxle will be refined even further in 1991 for selected cars and minivans. A larger 10-inch torque converter will be used with the 3.3 and 3.8-liter V6 engines for increased lockup clutch torque capacity and improved cooling through increased internal fluid flow. A higher overall top gear ratio of 2.52 to 1 will be used with most applications to provide faster acceleration and improved grade climbing ability in fourth gear. The all-wheel drive Caravan and Voyager models will use the 1990 ratio of 2.36 to 1, and cars with the 3.8-liter V6 will have a lower ratio of 2.19 to 1. Also, revised electronic control software within the transaxle will provide considerable drivability improvements. For 1991, the TorqueFlite automatic transaxle used with the Turbo 1 engine will feature a lockup torque converter to improve highway fuel economy. The 4-speed automatic transaxle used on Plymouth and Dodge Colt models has been improved for 1991. The transaxle now has 3 connectors to the control unit instead of the previous 2. The torque converter fluid coupling has been modified to improve acceleration from a stop. Shift feeling has been improved by a control unit shift time program. And the neutral to drive shift feel has been improved by changing the neutral drive control valve construction and operation. A new manual transaxle clutch disc will be introduced for turbocharged engines in 1991. The new disc design allows the transaxle input shaft and engine crankshaft to rotate on differing axes without inducing orbital bending motion, thereby eliminating gear rattle in neutral and in gear. And for 1991, all domestic U.S. passenger cars except Monaco will be equipped with a new corporate compact oil filter. Now, when this new filter is installed, the oil refill capacity is increased to 4.5 quarts. Two variations of a simpler, lighter weight fuel pump module will be used in all domestic U.S. passenger cars and minivans for 1991. A two-piece module will be used for Dodge Monaco and Caravan Voyager all-wheel drive models. And an integral pump reservoir module will be used on all other models. The new all-wheel drive system for Caravan Voyager will be available on models equipped with the 3.3-liter V6, ultra-drive automatic transaxle, and 15-inch wheels. The basic components of the system include a power transfer unit attached to a modified automatic transaxle case where the right half shaft extension would ordinarily be located. A viscous coupling consisting of a series of closely spaced discs operating in silicone fluid, alternately connected to the front and rear drive units. An overrunning clutch which allows the rear wheels to turn faster than the front wheels if the front wheels start to lock under hard braking. A dog clutch which provides all-wheel drive in reverse gear by bridging and locking out the overrunning clutch. A conventional open rear differential with a hypoid ring and pinion gear set. An open tubular prop shaft which transmits torque from the power transfer unit's rear output shaft to the viscous coupling. a rigid torque tube mounted aft of the viscous coupling and attached to the overrunning clutch rear final drive unit housing, and a rear final drive housing, which includes the overrunning and dog clutches, is mounted to the vehicle structure through rubber isolators. Minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Monaco, will also be equipped with new half-shaft outer CV joint boots made of a new Hytrel material for increased durability. In braking systems, optional four-wheel anti-lock brakes will be extended to a broader range of vehicles for 1991. Car lines adding ABS will be the Chrysler LeBaron sedan, coupe and convertible, and Town and Country, Dodge Daytona, Spirit, Caravan, and Monaco, and the Plymouth Acclaim, Voyager, and Laser. Three ABS systems will be used: Anti-Lock 10 on Caravan, Voyager, and Monaco, Anti-Lock 6 on LeBaron, Daytona, Spirit, and Acclaim, and an all-new anti-lock system for Laser. More information about these systems can be found in the 1991 New Model Highlights Reference Book. A braking system with a common family design for the front caliper will be standard on Chrysler LeBaron, Spirit Acclaim, Shadow Sundance, Dodge Dynasty, Monaco and Daytona, and minivans for 1991. The family caliper can be used with either 14 or 15 inch discs and has a single piston construction with two bore sizes available from a common casting. It has double pin slider operation and attaches to the steering knuckle with a bolt-on adapter. On all Colt models, the front disc brake caliper rigidity has been increased and the front brake pads are now made from an asbestos-free material. The rear drum brake shoe clearance auto-adjusting mechanism has been changed from a parking brake type to a service brake type operation. Minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Monaco, will use a Hub Unit 3 hub and bearing assembly, which mounts to the steering knuckle with bolts. The new unit replaces the cartridge type bearing, which was pressed on the steering knuckle. A fixed or tilt version of the corporate steering column, introduced in 1990, will now be available on Spirit Acclaim, Shadow Sundance, minivans, and all Dodge trucks, vans, and wagons, except Ram 50 models. A sport or luxury steering wheel will be available with a new column depending on the vehicle model. If a vehicle is ordered with automatic speed control, these steering wheels will incorporate new speed control switch housings and switch buttons along the lower surface of the steering wheel center housing. For 1991, minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Monaco, have been revised extensively to provide steering and handling improvements. Now, on these vehicles, the roll center has been raised, caster has been increased, the steering geometry has been revised, the power steering valving has been revised, the steering intermediate shaft coupling has been changed, and the steering ratios have been changed on some models. Now, for further information regarding individual vehicles, consult your service manual. Town and Country, Voyager, and Caravan will have a body computer for the first time in 1991. The computer is located behind the instrument panel, to the right of the steering column. The diagnostic connector is located under the instrument panel to the left of the steering column. Chrysler LeBaron, Dodge Monaco, Daytona, and Dakota will have an electrical system power distribution center located in the engine compartment. This feature will eliminate the use of fusible links and provide improved circuit overload protection for main electrical feed circuits. A convenient feature on Dodge Stealth models will be easy access to the ignition off-draw connector. The connector is located inside the power distribution center. Dodge trucks equipped with automatic speed control will receive new Accel and Decel features for 1991. These features function in the same manner as those introduced in 1990 on other Chrysler Motors passenger car models. Chrysler Imperial, New Yorker, and Dodge Dynasty models will be available with a remote keyless entry system, which uses a transmitter mounted in the driver's key fob and a receiver located in the car. The system is based on the same principle as an automatic garage door opener. Chrysler Imperial, New Yorker, LeBaron, and Dodge Dynasty will have a revised optional automatic temperature control system with an added sun sensor and coolant temperature sensor. The sun sensor measures the intensity of the incoming light to help the control system provide the appropriate proportion of airflow between the floor and instrument panel. The coolant temperature sensor provides input so that the control system inhibits blower operation until the engine coolant has warmed to a suitable level. Chrysler LeBaron, Spirit Acclaim, Shadow Sundance, and Dodge Daytona vehicles equipped with either a four-cylinder or 3-liter MMC V6 engine and air conditioning will have a new AC compressor. The new compressor will have 10 pistons for smooth, quiet operation. Chrysler Town & Country, Caravan, and Voyager will have all new instrument panels and clusters in either a standard or premium version for 1991. Some features of the new panels include a raised extended section in front of the driver, which includes an information center, leading edge control switches arranged in two pods in front of the driver for easy access, a panel center area with heater AC controls, audio system controls, and a switch module, a center console with a slide-out tray, ash receiver, cup holders, and storage box, and either a premium or standard instrument cluster, depending on model and option availability. In sound systems for 1991, minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Dodge Monaco and Shadow Sundance, will have a new graphic equalizer radio cassette player used in the Chrysler Infinity II audio system option. The system features redesigned controls for ease of operation. Imperial, New Yorker, and Dodge Dynasty have an available option of an enhanced Infinity speaker system called RS for reference standard. The RS system consists of 10 speakers in 6 locations and a trunk-mounted centralized 120-watt amplifier, which allows the speakers to be tailored for each location. New Yorker, LeBaron, Spirit Acclaim, Shadow Sundance, and Dodge Daytona will be equipped with a best-in-class front seat mechanism for fore and aft adjustment. Minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Monaco, will have improved door hinge bearings for 1991. These self-lubricating bearings will be installed on the hinge pivots and on the door check torsion bar pivots. In restraint systems for 1991, all vehicles equipped with airbags will have some refinements which include relocated vents, a raised collision deployment speed to 12 miles per hour, and an internal tether strap to limit the extent of deployment. Also, minivans and all U.S. passenger cars, except Monaco, will have unibelt and lap belt restraint systems with new latch plates and buckles. As a final note, you should be aware that headlight aiming on all vehicles is preset at the factory and requires no further adjustment before vehicle delivery, or when headlights are replaced during normal service. Well, this concludes our advanced look into the 1991 Chrysler Motors product line. I hope this videotape has provided you with an insight into the vehicles and vehicle systems that you'll be servicing in the coming model year. But remember that this videotape was simply an overview of the product line and technical features of the line. Additional information can be found in the 1991 New Model Highlights book provided with this tape. Of course, the information provided in the book and this tape was the most accurate data available at the time of printing and taping, and some information may change slightly by vehicle launch. Chrysler's Service and Parts Operations Service Training Group will be working diligently during the 1991 model year to keep you abreast of the latest changes in service and technology. And remember, your dedication to quality in the service department is critical to the success of your dealership. So let's help build customer loyalty and customer satisfaction through quality service and make 1991 a banner year for your dealership and your service department in Chrysler Motors.